baby, come on. You like me. You know you do. I'm a light guy. Listen to me. Just stop. Just stop. Come on. You like me.
Miss Golali, no game, please.
What happened to you anyway? You take off with the powder room and that's the last I see you.
Not really, Harry.
Harry was the other guy. I'm Sid. Sid Arbuck. You like me. Remember?
Miss Golali, I must protest.
Oh, darling, I'm sorry. I lost my key.
That was 2 weeks ago. You cannot go and ring my bell. You must please have yourself kimmed.
Well, that wouldn't do any good. I just lose them all.
I work. I have to sleep. But you always ring my bell.
Now, come on, baby. You like me. You know you do.
Well, I worship you, Miss Arbuck, but good night, Miss Arbuck.
Baby, what is this? You like me. I'm a light guy. Didn't I pick up the check of 5 people? Your friends. I never seen them before. And when you ask me for a little change for the powder room, what do I give you? A $50 bill.
In 30 seconds, I'm calling the police. The vice squad.
Oh, don't be angry, you dear little man. I won't do it again. And if you promise not to be angry, I might even let you take those pictures we mentioned.
When?
Sometime. Well, good night. Oh, hello, cat. Thanks for waking up. You want some breakfast? All right. Let's get you some milk. Okay. Here you go. It's all right. I've had mine, really. You can go ahead. Not hungry? All right. Well, let's get ready for bed then.
Moving into apartment 3A. They sent me the wrong key, so I couldn't get the apartment open. I hope I didn't wake you.
Oh, it's quite all right. Could happen to anyone. Very frequently does. Well, good night.
Listen, I hate to bother you, but can I ask you for one more favor? Can I use your phone?
Sure, why not?
Well, nice little place you have here, huh? Are you moving in too?
No, I've been here for about a year.
Oh.
The phone's right over there on the floor by the bed. Well, it was, oh no. Oh, I remember, I stuck it in the suitcase. It kind of muffles the sound.
Oh, I'm so sorry, I didn't see him there. Is he all right?
Oh, sure he is. You're okay, aren't you, Cat? He's a tough guy, though. He can be grumpy. Did he bite you?
No.
All right. Poor no-name slob. You know, I don't feel like I have the right to give him one. I mean, he'll just have to wait till he belongs to somebody. Oh, we don't belong to each other. We just took up by the river one day. He's an independent and so am I. Well, I don't even want to own anything until I found a place where me and things go together. I'm not sure where that is, but I know what it's like. It's like Tiffany's.
You mean the jewelry store?
That's right. I'm crazy about Tiffany's. Listen, you know those days when you've got the mean reds?
The mean reds, you mean like the blues?
No, the blues are just because you're getting fat. Or maybe it's been raining too long. You're sad, that's all. Oh, but the mean reds are horrible. Suddenly you're afraid and you don't know what you're afraid of. Well, except that you know something bad is going to happen. Only you don't know what it is. You ever get that feeling?
Sure.
Well, when I get it, the only thing that does me any good is to jump in a cab and go to Tiffany's. Oh, it calms me down right away, the quietness and the proud look of it. Nothing very bad could happen to you there. Not with those kind men in their nice suits and that lovely smell of silver and alligator wallets. Oh, grumpy cat. Oh, I'm sorry, you wanted something.
What Someone was supposed to meet me here. This is 10 o'clock Thursday morning, isn't it?
Thursday? Is this Thursday?
I think so.
Thursday? Oh, no, it can't be. It's too gruesome.
Mrs. Fanstock, please. Oh, she has. I see. No, no message. Thank you. Hey, what's so gruesome about Thursday?
Nothing. It's just I can never remember when it's coming up. Wednesday nights, I generally just don't go to bed at all because I have to be up to catch the 10:45. And they're so particular about visiting hours. Oh, would you, you darling, and look under the bed and see if you can find a pair of alligator shoes?
Sure.
Well, I've got to do something about the way I look. I mean, a girl just can't go to Sing Sing with a green face.
Sing Sing?
That's right. All the visitors make an effort to look their best. It's only fair.
Is this it?
Black alligator. And if you come across a black brassiere with a broken strap and a safety pin, I can use that too. Actually, it's very touching the way the women wear their prettiest things.
As I understand this, what we're doing here is getting you ready to visit someone at Sing Sing.
That's right. Oh, you can always tell what kind of a person a man really thinks you are by the earrings he gives you. I must say, the mind reels. Oh, pearls, pearls, pearls. Not those. I think I left them in the bathroom. Would you mind going to look for that?
May one ask whom?
Whom what? Oh, who I go to visit, you mean?
I guess that's what I mean.
Well, I don't know if I should even discuss it. But, well, they never told me not to tell anyone. Only you've got to cross your heart and kiss your elbow.
I'll try.
Probably read about him. His name's Sally Tomato.
The gangster?
Oh, they never proved it. The only thing they could ever prove was that he cheated a little on his income tax. Anyway, all I know is he's a darling old man. Oh, he was never my lover or anything like that. In fact, I never even knew him until after he was in prison. But I adore him now. I mean, I've been going to see him every Thursday for 7 months. Now I think I'd go even if he didn't pay me. Oh, what about the shoes?
I can only find one. Wait, he pays you.
That's right. Or anyway, his lawyer does. If he is a lawyer, which I doubt, because he doesn't seem to have an office, just an answering service. And he always wants me to meet him at Hamburger Heaven. Oh, there you are, you sneak. Ugh. Anyway, about 7 months ago, this so-called lawyer, Mr. O'Shaughnessy, sent me this telegram asking me to meet him at Hamburger Heaven. Then he asked me how I'd like to cheer up a lonely old man and pick up 100 a week at the same time. I told him, look, darling, you've got the wrong Holly Golightly. Oh, I wasn't impressed by this honorarium either. You can do as well as that on trips to the powder room. Any gent with the slightest chic will give a girl a $50 bill for the girls drawn. And I always ask for cab fare too. That's another 50. But then he said his client was Sally Tomato. He said dear old Sally had seen me at Elmo's or somewhere and had admired me a la distance. So wouldn't it be a good deed if I went to visit him once a week? Well, I couldn't say no. It was too romantic.
It doesn't seem to just let anyone visit a prisoner.
Oh, they don't. In fact, they make quite a boring fuss. I'm supposed to be his niece. Well, how do I look?
Very good. I must say I'm amazed. Odd, actually.
Oh, you were a darling to help. I could never have done it without you.
It was a pleasure, really. Call me anytime. I'm right across the hall. Well, I will be as soon as I can move in. You mean for an hour's conversation, he pays you $100?
Well, that's right. As soon as I meet him and give him the weather report.
Well, it sounds to me like you could get into a lot of trouble.
How?
Well, there must be some law about false identity, and you're not really his niece. And what about the weather report?
Taxi, taxi! Oh, nothing but bills. That's just the message I give Mr. O'Shaughnessy, so we know I've really been up there. Sally tells me things to say like, oh, there's a hurricane in Cuba. It's cloudy in Palermo. Things like that.
Taxi.
Oh, you don't have to worry. I've taken care of myself for a long time. Oh, Paul, I'm late. I know it. Oh, don't tell me you were locked out. Didn't you get the key?
It's all right. My neighbor heard Miss Golightly was kind enough to let me in. Miss Golightly's on her way to Sing Sing. Just visiting, of course. Miss Golightly, I'd like you to meet my decorator, Mrs. Fanstoke.
How do you do?
How do you do? Well, let me look at you. Is the flight absolutely ghastly?
It's been only 3 weeks since I left you in Rome. It seems like years.
Well, it's nice to meet you, and thanks again for your help.